Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Natalie Merchant. And the song that we are going to react to is Carnival. It is our first time single take on his reaction.
Paralyzed by what my eyes have found, by what
Nice.
Wow.
This is thought provoking. Unique lyrics, I would say, and I like the way it was sung. I like the way the music is constructed, arranged in this. It started with a lot of use of the bass guitar and the unique drums that were playing all along. There was organ in the background that was, I guess, playing throughout the song very gently, just being there, making its presence known in certain parts. And I like the guitar work, supporting her sing so amazingly. It was very subtle guitar work that was constantly there with her voice. Neither the voice was tempering or affecting the guitar sound, nor the guitar was overpowering her voice. It was so beautifully arranged. They complemented each other.
Yeah, it was a mesmerizing combination of her vocals with that guitar sound and the drums.
Yeah.
You know, it reminded me so much of Santana and Carlos Santana mainly. His music collabs reminded me so much of that. I wonder who this guitar player was. Did an
exceptional, bit of African sound
exceptional
because
job.
Of the drums.
Yeah, native sound even.
Yeah.
Won't just call it African, can be called native.
Yeah. And there was a refreshing sound of the backup singer, soul singer, who was backing her up. I don't know whether she did that part or someone else was doing that. Towards the end, if you notice, when you listen to the song, there is a soul singer who's singing like a shadow to her, but I don't know if it was done by her later on or it was some other singer doing that.
That I wouldn't know. It's difficult to tell. I remember the humming, and then that was done by her only, I think.
Uh-huh.
The humming bits towards the end.
Mm-hmm.
It was beautifully sung, beautifully arranged,
mm-hmm.
and I enjoyed it thoroughly. The guitar was very, very good. Very good.
Amazing.
Definitely.
Yeah.
It was as good as... if I had to compare it, it was as good as any guitarist in any band. In fact, it resembled mostly Santana's work, but that may be just an inspiration in the creation of this song. Because obviously Carlos Santana, the sound is a little bit different of his guitar.
Mm-hmm.
But this was really good, really good. It was a unique choice of instruments.
It is, for sure. Coming to the lyrics, Carnival, I think she's talking about the show Biz Carnival here. That's what I think I can connect with the most by the examples that were put in the lyrics, such as, you know, how actors and other people are around her. She shares the time, the cheap thrill seeker and things like that. Then after that, she spoke about the riches and the poverty, both of them together, some diamonds, etc., mentioning all those things after you become a star or you get into the showbiz, how things drastically change. You find yourself on the opposite side of what you were before that.
It in fact reminded me of Moroccan market.
Okay.
The Moroccan marketplace that we see so often on TV, in travel shows, cookery shows and all that. Reminded me of something like that. For me it was like an interpretation of a very busy marketplace,
mm-hmm.
what all is happening there. But yes, I guess it's about the industry, music and movie
and
industry.
And then she also went on to speak about some spiritual guru or something like that, who kind of, saves the person, saves the celebrities by healing them or teaching them certain philosophies. And people run after those gurus after that, because they worked with these people or, they helped them, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So all those things mentioned, she kept questioning, am I hypnotized? Am I mesmerized? Am I wrong? Am I right? Am I wise? What exactly it is? Because she doesn't know, half of the time they are lost in the glitz of the world, of their world. Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to BIC RUNGA. And the song is Sway. Now this name reminds me the movie Wedding Ringer, where the BIC name is used because it's a popular, what do you call it, the shaving kit brand in the West. And this name reminds me of the movie. If you haven't watched it, you will get the connection when you watch it.
Wedding Ringer.
Yeah.
Don't stray, don't ever go away. the better of me sometimes. When you and I collide, I fall into an ocean of you. Pull me up in time, don't let me drown. Let me down, I say it's all because of you. And here I go, losing my control. I'm practicing your name so I can say it to your face. It doesn't seem right to look you in the eye. Let all the things you mean to me come tumbling out my mouth. Indeed, it's time I'm telling you why. I say it's infinitely true. Doubt, it makes me so tired. I feel so uninspired. My head is battling with my heart. My logic has been torn apart. And now it all turns sour. Comes sweet in the every afternoon.
Striking, is it something extraordinary or something that I will remember it for a long time? I don't see any qualities like that in this song.
Yeah, I completely agree. The lyrics were too repetitive. We often say that, but you know, the reason we say that is because it makes it quite boring.
It does.
It makes it more and more boring, unless the,
especially when there are not too many elements.
There are some
in the song.
Songs where the repetition is desired.
Makes sense. Yeah.
It makes sense because it's done so uniquely. It's done so beautifully. you will love hearing it again and again, but this is not the case here, as in the case with many other songs. So it's very repetitive, that say and all that.
Stay.
Say, you stay and all that. It just went on and on and on. How much, what was it of the song content? If you actually time it, how much it was sung, out of the lyrical time of the song, the singing time of the song, I guarantee you to occupy 65% of this song. That is how repetitive it was, which left around 35% for unique verses. And that's always, I mean, 65% is an estimate. It may have been higher.
Sometimes a song can be a masterpiece even after having very limited lyrics, very repetitive lyrics, but the musical arrangement and the music by itself is so strong, so rich, so mind-blowing that people don't care what exactly is happening with the lyrics, how is it sung. It's just too catchy for the ears for you to think about anything else, and people listen to those songs again and again and again. But if you don't have music like that and you don't have vocals that strong, and then the lyrics too aren't anything extraordinary, the entire song goes down. And that's exactly what
and,
it is.
And we've noticed in the last song, the Natalie Merchant song, in that you had the guitar, you know, was doing an outstanding job. Here the drummer was kind of a little bit loud, kind of making it like an easy listening tune. But because even the drummer played just one way of playing it, one tune on the drums, one beat rather, it just sounded ordinary.
It's
so
fake,
in the it definitely, after hearing that song, this wasn't a good listen. And maybe if I listened to it separately, my review would be even harsher, because that's when I actually noticed several things in isolation, namely the lyrics, the tune, the instruments selected, the vocals, and because it followed that, I'm comparing it to only that right now. And definitely this is nowhere close to that. Lyrically, vocally,
musically,
the guitar sound, everything, yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't much actually.
It isn't. It's not unique. It's not rare. It's something rare to come across. And it's easily forgettable music. That's what I would say. On the first listen, it does sound good. That's how it is. But if I compare it with other music, also, if my own self, will I be choosing it over good music? This won't be a choice for me.
Listen itself, it didn't sound good to me.
Okay.
So yeah, let me clear that out in case you think both of us are speaking.
No, for the first time it was okay for me. But am I going to listen to it again? No.
It wasn't even good, to be honest. That's it for this one. Goodbye.